can create job opportunities to millions of people earning millions of dollars at least for a decade. See, future and fortune, never it can be evergreen. You must be prepared for alternatives. One, something may fade in the society, number one. Something may grow advanced in the society. Something may grow different in the society. If there is a language, whether a software language or any other useful language, we can have an advanced version. Some versions can become totally obsolete. Some versions can become very limited. Pascal, Fortran, everybody, if you see the MCA book, it will start with basic, Lotus, 1, 2, 3, everything, etc. Most of the languages are limited. Few of the languages are obsolete. And Maya, Java, and other things, they are growing advanced. So you must not expect a static future. If you are static, the process of the development of the society is dynamic. You should also be dynamic. If it is advanced, I am ready to read. If it is obsolete, I am ready to delearn it, forget it. If something is limited, I will grow unlimited. So you have to take the challenges of society. It is natural that something will fade, something will be destroyed, something will grow, something will be advanced, something will become totally different, something may become difficult or limited. These are all the natures of the university. This is the natures of the universal wisdom. So if you are not prepared dynamically for that, you cannot get all of these benefits. Now recently they have predicted Ericsson people, they survived, that 2011, $177 billion is there waiting for this multimedia industry in future. There is a science which is known as future consumer predictability. How we can predict about, by understanding the trend of the present, how we can predict about the future tendency or the future trend of the consumers and their levels. By that they have predicted that $177 billion of industry is there. It is there evergreen in email industry, in advertisement placements. We are having a lot of possibilities, and social connectivity networks we are having, convergent services. New convergent services. What are convergent services? Two works done in a single handset. Five works are done in a single handset. Single handset operated with multi-access or multi-denial or multi-access modes. Single thing having the work efficiency of 10 sets. Either work efficiency or load efficiency or handability like color, complexion, slimness, weight and various other factors, they are known as convergence. So this type of converging the technologies, that is also having its own boost. So innumerable opportunities are there. How to develop these opportunities? Number one, we have to create the basic creativity inside the mind. Creativity is inherent. It should be born inside. No book can create creativity. Number two, it can be inherited. Either inspiration model of some people outside or from your parents. You should have three atmospheres. One is a compatible atmosphere, second is conducive atmosphere, third thing is competitive atmosphere. For example, if you see a book or the syllabus, you must feel like doing that. That is known as compatibility. If the infrastructure is beautiful with either AC coverage or with good machineries or good looking or advanced looking, then that induces, boosts your curriculum or boosts your characteristic affinity towards dealing with those things. The third thing is competitive. If 10 people are studying with you and somebody is studying more than you, you get an urgent competition. You should not get jealousy or haterness towards the person. Naturally, as a healthy reflection, you should get competition. Seeing the book, compatibility. Sitting inside the classroom, you should get conduciveness. Seeing your co-students, you should get competitiveness. So already existing inherited and inherent creativity skill should be boosted by these three major things. Second thing, there is no school for the real evaluation of the student. One is talent identification. Is your talent identified by any of your masters? If it is there, it may be occasional or accidental. Really, it is not possible. Number one, talent identification. Second is talent shaping, how to shape your talent. Third thing is, if your talent has some problem, like you are having stage fear, you are having public fear, or you are having some stammering inside to present yourself, that is known as treatment. And fourth thing is known as boosting, how to boost your talent. Fifth thing is multi-level adaptation. If a person is having a single talent, how to boost it and make it appeal applicable for various other operations coming on the same field or different fields. So talent identification, shaping, treatment, boosting and multiversal adaptabilities, there is no academy for that. It is not done your elementary school, it is not done your domestic academy, that is by your parents, it is not individually developed by you, by seeing others are learning from these things. In higher collegiate studies, you don't have the time to study, or you have crossing that level of obedience to listen to somebody's advice and to mold yourself. So these are all the problems of the modern society. I wish that any institution of multimedia should have at least a 3 months course first. Instead of having 6 months or 1 month course, let 3 months be more. See, if the 6 months of the course is taught for somebody's earning, to make the earning more realizable and relishable, why can't we add with the 3 more months? 3 more months without any tools, computer unaided designing. CUD, CUD, not CAD. CAD means computer aided designing, computer unaided designing. The natural, spontaneous spring of creativity and imagination should be taken by making the person to mix with people, meeting artists, going to environmental eco-friendly places like forest, streams, etc. Whatever they, if they are having nature response or animal response, bird response, anybody should have their own taste with machines, with innovations, with the persons, with artistic styles, with divine images. They will be having their own taste. So we can tune and shape the taste by subjective and objective learnings by means of at least a 3 months of education, without which it is totally becoming useless. And the Vedas, they have given few exercises which I want to say. One is Prakriti Upasana. Second is Rupa Varna Dyuti Dhyana. Third is Akara Prakara Sankara Dhyana. Fourth is Nirupa Bhava Dhyana. So Nisarga Dhyana or Prakriti Upasana is you have to contemplate upon nature. Daily, any designer, even if you are artificially working with machines or something, everything has come from nature. Artificialism is nothing but a crooked representation or a clarified representation or a connective representation of nature. It cannot be something different from that. So any person, 10 minutes at least, they have to meditate, they have to have the meditation about nature, about the placid nature, about the beauty, about the order, about the peace and message of nature. They have to close their eyes and work out. It is known as Nisargopasana, by which they can draw the figures of nature, draw the figures of human beings, draw the figures of machines, draw the figure of animated structures, for everything. It is very useful. It is Nisargopasana. And second is Rupa Varna Dyuti Dhyana. They should not meditate about anything else except three things. Rupa is shapes, like a polygon, hexagon, octagon, rhombus, then elliptical, parabolical, various other shapes and forms, like regular and irregular forms, they have to meditate. And Varna, they have to meditate about colors. You know that narrow lag they have given, we know about Sapta Varna. They have given Sapta Sahasra Varna, 7000 shades are being given. All minutest, delicate, infinitesimally, negligibly, optically subjectable shades are being given, thousands in number. So we have to understand how things are made in three methodologies. One is fading, second is grading, third thing is fusing. There are three things in color. Especially these people, I think that they have to study separately about chromatography, chromometry and chromatics. That is not there in graphics and multimedia, unfortunately. That should be read by people. So how to create colors, how to fade colors, how to grade colors and fuse, they have to work out the inside. Technically, they can very immediately do that. That is the second thing. Dyuti is light. We must understand what is dimness, what is darkness, how to increase and reduce the contrast, color sensitiveness, tintness, taint and sharpness of the light intensity and structure we have to make. How to make color shadows, color shades, color platforms, highly intensive color orientations and light orientations they can identify by means of a triangular study of these things, Rupa, Varna and Dyuti. Third thing is Akara, Prakara and Sankara. Akara means you imitate a form and imagine it in your mind. Prakara means what are all the innumerable organs that are situated there. Remove them and unite them. And Sankara means contra-unite them and contra-remove them. So using something, use, amuse and fuse, he used to say in English for that. So Akara, Prakara and Sankara. We have to imagine forms, remove their forms, reunify them, and we have to make the fusion permutation possibilities as much as we can. That will kindle you more to get more enthusiasm, that will develop more conceptualization and visualization in your industrial as well as individual work. It will do that. And Bhava Dhyana is very much important. It is thinking about abstracts. What is failure? How it can be exhibited? How it can be vociferously exhibited, inertly exhibited, silently exhibited, verbally exhibited, optically exhibited, physically, gesticulatively exhibited. All of these terms are to be studied. How to express failure by your physical movements, by your just eye movements. Just as in Bharatanatyam, they used to show everything by their eye.